Hello and welcome. It's another week and it's time for another issue of Outlook magazine. And here it is. This is our latest issue and we'll be discussing today, as always, what you have in this issue. I am Rohan Banerjee, the editor of Outlook, and joining me today in the conversation are Arindam Mukherjee, who is our business editor, and Tribhuvan Tiwari, who is our senior photographer. Now, as you can see, a very glitzy cover, but it's a very serious subject. It's Modi economics. And we have taken a very balanced look at what Prime Minister Modi's economic policies have delivered, what has been achieved, and possibly what hasn't been achieved. It's a very balanced audit. Months before the next elections, we are taking one hard look at Modinomics. Arindam, who anchored the story, Arindam, why do you think that people should be interested in this story?
People would be interested because economics is something that touches everyone, and economic issues are connected with everyone's lives, their incomes, their money, and their living, basically. And it would touch everyone in some way or the other. So what happens in the economic arena would affect each person in the country, some very significantly, some in a lesser way.
True. And it's a very serious subject. But we gave it a touch of fun because, as you know, a few weeks from now it will be Christmas. So Mr. Modi is in the guise of Santa and he's carrying goodies for us. This is the opening spread of the story. It really looks stunning. This is a photograph from the recent farmers' protest. And as you know, thousands of farmers marched on Delhi. And it takes you, gives you a lot actually. And would you like to talk a little bit to Arindam on what has worked for Modi and what hasn't worked for Modi?
Yeah, sure. See, what has worked undoubtedly, and that is visible on the ground across the country, is the progress that we've seen in the roads and highway sector. There is results on the ground. Highways have been built, good quality roads have been built. Of course, this was the dream of the former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee, but that has fructified only now. The Congress government hasn't been able to do anything. In fact, we've mentioned in the story that there's a 73% increase in actual roads which have been built by the NDA government over the previous government. And that is a huge achievement.
73?
Yes. That's big. So that's a big achievement. That's a big achievement. And everyone is benefiting from those. This is the Eastern Peripheral Expressway that we've given a picture, which connects Delhi to the eastern states. But apart from that, if you go across the country, and I was talking to one of our colleagues and he was saying that in Jorhat, there was one stretch of road which was for the last 15 years, the respective governments hadn't paid notice to it and it was almost kaccha. Now, in the last few months, the BJP government has got it done. So we must give all credit to
Nitin Gadkari. So roads and highways is one thing.
Then, of course, digitization and digital payments has taken off in a big way, which is an offshoot of the demonetization. The demonetization didn't succeed the way it was intended to be, but digitization has succeeded. So if you look at the number of e-payments and digital payments that is happening, that has taken a quantum leap. It's become an order of the day today. Before November 16, 2016, 2 years ago, this was not the case. I mean, now everyone talks about Paytm and MobiQuick and UPI and all. Every payment is being, even e-commerce payments are being done digitally, which was not the case 2 years ago.
And TaxNet has also now
increased. TaxNet has increased because of the demonetization and the GST. And there's been a 15 to 20% increase in the number of people who are actually filing returns and paying tax now. So that's a significant achievement. So these the government should be given credit for.
But as I said earlier, it's a very balanced audit. Both the pluses and negative, the minuses have found their rightful place in this issue when we have done. So just as Arindam explained that there have been certain positives and there have been some negatives as well.
Right. Yeah. Probably negatives are a bit more. I mean, we spoke about the positives which the government should be given credit for. Now, the negatives is the biggest move of this government, the biggest economic move was the demonetization. Now, demonetization did not succeed beyond increasing the tax net, and increasing the tax net was not one of its objectives. The objective was to wean out black money and counterfeit currency. Now, 99% of the currency that was taken out of circulation has come back into the system. So where is the black money gone? Now, the entire premise on which they had mounted the exercise was wrong, because, and we have quoted experts in the story who say that 99% of the black money is not in currency. It's in gold, it's in real estate, it's in foreign banks and all. Only 1% is there. So why mount such an exercise for 1% of the black money?
Postmortem of demonetization has been done adequately. And besides postmortem, what are the other things that you think that Mr. Modi has failed to deliver so far?
MSMEs, medium and small and medium enterprises, have their condition was not very good earlier also. And post demonetization in GST, their condition has worsened actually. Now, we must remember that the small micro industries employ 97.5% of the MSME sector. And that's a huge number. If they are affected, they can pull down the GDP growth, and they have pulled down the GDP growth by a good 1% this time, which is a significant amount considering that India is growing by only 7.5%.
And employment is another
thing that employment and skill development were its focus areas. And I'm sorry to say that the government has failed to sort of deliver on these issues, especially skill development, which was a big focus area for the Modi government. Beyond the initial work, nothing has really happened. The NSDC, which was a focus body for that, has remained a government body. It was supposed to be a public-private partnership. It hasn't delivered at all.
And what about Make in India?
Make in India, again, has remained in the government. Both Make in India and Smart Cities, these were very good initiatives to sort of take forward and to sort of implement.
They were good initiatives.
Very good initiatives, very well-intended initiatives, but they haven't really gone beyond the first level. And that is what that could be called a failure of the government.
So you will get both the pluses and minuses here, and you will find a lot of interesting voices.
One more thing I think I should point out is that farmers' lot, agriculture and farmers' lot on one hand and the social sector on the other, have got very little. From its first year of this government, 2014, they reduced the outlay on social sectors, on health and education. It's only the last year, which was the last full budget of this government, that they started looking into this sector. But by that time, it was too late. And farmers have been complaining despite the MSP, the minimum support price. Nothing has been done for them.
So as Arindam says, so basically it's been a mixed bag, and possibly the minuses outweigh the pluses.
Yes.
And that is what we have tried to capture on this cover. So you can see the Santa is carrying a bag of goodies. Gas cylinder, possibly his Ujjala scheme has worked.
Yes.
So that's popping out and shining brightly. GST, it's kind of an EP. There are implementation problems, but it's carrying along.
There are good and there are bad in GST. Yeah.
But rupee has fallen.
Rupee has been falling, and the demonetization effect also.
Yeah.
Is
and Make in India, it hasn't really progressed much. So we captured it. It's Christmas. It's Santa Claus's time. And we decided to go with it. Lots of voices you'll find. This is a issue from a farmer, this is a writer from a farmer's, very good I would say, from the farmer's point of view. We have a very good, I read this and I thought that this was great. One interesting piece, an opinion piece from Pranab Sen, who was the former chief statistician of this government. And he says that the government has had big achievements, but it's somehow in denial over demonetization. So overall, a fantastic cover, which I guess you like. It enriches all of us and really does an in-depth, unbiased balance sheet of Mr. Modi's economic achievements or so far, right? And as always, this issue of ours has a mix of stories. And one of the things that I'm exceptionally proud about in this particular issue is a fantastic picture gallery that we have done from the city of Allahabad. And these pictures were shot by our photographer Tribhuvan Tiwari. He will talk about a little. But just look at this. These are street murals. So the city, this is the place where Kumbh Mela will take place in January.
January, 15th January.
Yeah. So large parts of the city is being painted up. Entire buildings are being painted up. These are much, much bigger in scale than wall graffitis that we get to see. Entire buildings, structures are being painted. I mean, just look at this. This is stunning pictures. Appa, Allahabad kaise pahunche?
Allahabad actually ek book ke liye main gaya hua tha aur wahan pe dekha ki 5 se aur 6 baar pehle bhi ja chuka hu Allahabad mein. वहाँ पे सिर्फ साइकिल रिक्शा और हॉर्न के अलावा और कुछ संगम एक ज़्यादा मशहूर है वहाँ पे, लेकिन इस बार 2 से 3 लाख वॉल जो है पेंट कर रहे हैं, कुंभ की तैयारी कर रहे हैं.
दो से तीन
लाख
और बजट अपेरेंटली इज 30 crores,
22 30,
इट्स अ ह्यूज लॉट ऑफ मनी,
और 2 से 3 हजार आर्टिस्ट जो है वहाँ पे काम कर रहे हैं, और इस बार जब लोग कुंभ में जाएंगे तो अलग से इलाहाबाद दिखेगा, इस तरह से कोई सिटी अभी तक पेंट नहीं हुई है,
ये पूरा सिटी पेंट कर रहे हैं,
पूरा सिटी पेंट, 2 से 3 लाख स्क्वायर मीटर में जो भी आ रहा है,
2 से 3 लाख स्क्वायर मीटर पेंट कर रहे हैं
जी।
एंड apart from this, I would suggest that pick up this issue because this picture gallery is actually stunning and worth taking a look. We have back of the book, we have very good book reviews as always. Then we have excerpted from Firoz Varun Gandhi's recent book, Rural Manifesto. I found the book to be very interesting. Our former Indian cricketer VVS Lakshman came out with his autobiography, and we have an interview with him. A great fascinating guy, a very understated performer who never showed much emotions on the field, but a great cricketer. December 6th was when Babri Masjid was demolished in 1991, right? And we have a piece from Prolay Kanungo, one of the most sought after thinkers, on the relevance of Ayodhya today and why it keeps popping up in the political narrative. And we have also have a very interesting story on fake news factories, like inside the fake news factory in India, and the ramifications of fake news is huge. You know that over last several months, many people across this country have been physically lynched; they died because of fake news. And not only that, fake news now possibly a few months time threatens to influence our elections, 2019 Lok Sabha and Assembly elections. So. It's a very serious story, pretty worrisome trend, and how both sides can be accused of fudging, doctoring videos and news. So overall, as always, I'm very proud of this issue. Do pick up the copy and do let us know your feedback. Thank you. See you again next week.